Good evening, everyone. We welcome you today as we celebrate and thank God for the ministry of Reverend Dr. Atif Gindi in managing the Evangelical Theological Seminary in Cairo, ETSC. And we pray for a successful start and an encouraging start in the ministry of Reverend Dr. Hani Youssef in the time ahead in his management of ETSC. Let us, at the beginning of this ceremony, bow our hearts before the Lord and lift all the parts of our celebration before the throne of grace. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, from all our hearts, because you are alive, and because you, Lord, are present in our midst. Thank you, Lord, because you are the God of history. And thank you, because in you we live and move and have our being. Thank you, Lord, for our gathering around the throne of grace at these moments as we look to the Master Teacher, the Head of the Church, the victorious leader, the risen Lord. And we pray, Lord, that you will dominate all the parts of this ceremony with your Holy Spirit so that we may see you glorified, Lord, in every minister and see you glorified in every part. We pray that you, Lord, will satisfy our hearts through seeing you and enjoying you. In the name of Jesus, Amen. Amen. Please be seated. Dear friends, according to the program in our hands, we praise the Lord for having our brother engineer Nasif Sobhi, who will lead us today in more than one part of singing. So now we will listen to and enjoy some songs with our brother Nasif. Then we will hear a word from the head of the Synod of the Nile in its current session, Reverend Kamal Rushdie. Afterwards, you will watch a video titled A Journey of a Challenge and Success, and we will conclude this first part with some other songs with engineer Nasif Sobhi. We bless your name every day, and our praises are long-lasting joys. All the journey, heat and clouds, is full of victorious shouting for joy to you, Lord. Let's glorify this God who is worthy of praise. We bless your name every day, and our praises are long-lasting joys. All the journey, heat and clouds, is full of victorious shouting for joy to you, Lord. Years go by, and at every moment we realize that you are a faithful God. Help us thank you joyfully and speed your coming. Amen. Come. Let our goal and the purpose of our life in our songs throughout the years be to live, to glorify, testify, and proclaim our heart's devotion to you, Lord. Our heart's devotion to you, Lord. To you, Lord. We live in your shelter without groaning, abiding in your shadow joyfully, trusting your faithful promise that you keep us for you, Lord. Years go by, and at every moment we realize that you are a faithful God. Help us thank you joyfully and speed your coming. Amen. Come. Let our goal and the purpose of our life in our songs throughout the years be to live, to glorify, testify, and proclaim our heart's devotion to you, Lord. Our heart's devotion to you, Lord. To you, Lord. Your love fills us in a long night, You are our Lord and friend. Your face guides us with shining light. We get to our home through you, Lord. Years go by, and at every moment we realize that you are a faithful God. Help us thank you joyfully and speed your coming. Amen. Come. Let our goal and the purpose of our life in our songs throughout the years be to live to glorify, testify, and proclaim our heart's devotion to you, Lord. Our heart's devotion to you, Lord. To you, Lord. To you, Lord. Please be seated.
الفاضل الدكتور القس
Reverend Dr. Andrea Zaki, head of the denomination. I thank God for your presence and safety.
الفاضل القس يوسف راعي الكنيسة
Reverend Yusuf, pastor of this church and chairman of the board of ECSC. Thanks to your church and the heart that is always open for us.
الدكتور القس عاطف مهني والأخت
Reverend Dr. عاطف جندي and sister Manal.
الدكتور القس هاني يوسف
President Reverend Dr. Hani Yusuf Hanna. Hanna is the fourth name, but I know that Dr. Hani is the son of Elder Yusuf Kustandi, who is now with the Lord and who was an elder of our Second Evangelical Church, and Sister Lucy. It is very difficult for me, and when Reverend Dr. Tharwat told me that I was supposed to deliver a word, it is really hard for me from all my heart to speak to great scholars who carry the mission of ETSC that I am honored to have been one day a student who learned there, and I am still indebted to great professors
ومن بينهم
among whom allow me to mention my father dear Reverend Emil Zaki thanks to this seminary whom I owe a lot and will continue to be indebted to it and I would love to quote my teacher Reverend Dr. Andrea Zaki all of us the speaker being on top of the list are indebted to the church and to the Lord who gave us far more abundantly than all that we deserve or think. I have to say this word. And I will be short because I want my word to be from the heart. Dr. Atif and Dr. Hani, allow me to say that they are godly in a time when we need godliness, in a time when we need a right, sound, close relationship that connects humans with God and connects humans with fellow humans and connects humans with themselves. I want to congratulate you, my friends, my great, honorable teachers. We can say about you, blessed is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in his ways. You shall eat the fruit of the labor of your hands. You shall be blessed and it shall be well with you. You teach not only the academic aspect, however important, but what is more glorious is that you apply what you teach. And this is what we need these days. And this role is something I can testify about concerning the two of you as you present a model of a great academy like ETSC. May our Lord always guide you with blessings. Dr. Atif, I am indebted to you because you are one of those who encouraged the speaker practically every time we met together in every conversation between you and me. Dr. Haney, you are a son of my church that I am honored to minister in for almost 30 years now. And I saw in your deceased father an example of a reverend elder. And I gave this witness last Sunday before my congregation that is honored to have one of her children as president of ECSC. We all approach this wonderful place to which we are indebted, and the speaker is the first of those. I am also glad that I am contemporary of Reverend Dr. Andrea Zaki, to whom I owe love and owe all friendship and intimacy that unites and joins us. What I am saying to the two of you, dear distinguished and honorable presidents, teachers who imitate their master, your mission is important and your role is wonderful. Keep giving.
استمروا في محبتكم. استمروا
keep
أن توصلوا رسالة الحب والسلام والخير للجميع. الرب معكم.
May the Lord be with you.
تولى الدكتور القس عاطف مهني عمادة الكلية عام 2000، ومنذ ذلك الحين وهو يعمل متكلا على نعمة المسيح ويضع نصب عينيه أن يقوم ويبني عمل الرب. لقد قام الدكتور عاطف بحشد فريق ملهم بخدمة السيد وأصل القيم الجوهرية التي تجمع مجتمع الكلية، وكان الهدف من وراء كل ذلك هو تمجيد المسيح. ويمكن تقسيم فترة خدمة دكتور القس عاطف مهني عبر 21 عاما إلى أربعة مراحل. المرحلة الأولى وهي مرحلة الخروج من الأزمة والتي امتدت من عام 2000 إلى 2004، حيث واجهت الكلية الكثير من التحديات مما جعلها تعمل على استعادة الثقة والبناء في مجالات العلاقات والدعم المالي وجودة المنشآت والبنية التحتية، وكذلك من الناحية الأكاديمية حيث تم إنشاء قسم للإرساليات وتدشين برنامج لخدمة العلمانيين. ساهم كل هذا في نهضة الكنيسة والكرازة وزرع الكنائس والعمل المرسل. كذلك اهتم الدكتور عاطف بتشجيع الأساتذة والموظفين عن طريق خلق مناخ وبيئة مناسبة للعمل، حيث تم إحداث تجديدات في مكاتب الأساتذة والموظفين وسكن الطلبة والعمال.
Moreover,
وكذلك بدأ الاهتمام ببناء هيئة التدريس المصرية، حيث تم تعيين الدكتور القس هاني حنا والدكتور القس ثروت وهيب عام 2001 كمعيدين في اللاهوت النظامي والإرساليات.
The second phase was that of internal development and extension. This extended from 2004 to 2012. It encompassed all areas, beginning with the education system, as the number of full-time faculty increased to 18 faculty members, half of whom had PhDs from the most prestigious universities in the world. Moreover, the number of students rose considerably from 76 students in 2000 to more than 500 male and female students in 2020-2021.
كما تم تطوير طرق تشكيل وتدريب الطلاب في المجالات الروحية والفكرية والعلمية واكتساب مهارات الخدمة. كذلك تم افتتاح أفرع للكلية في المنيا وأسيوط وسوهاج وإعادة افتتاح فرع الإسكندرية. كما تم تجديد الفصول الدراسية بالوسائل التكنولوجية وتطوير المكتبة لتناسب البحث والاطلاع مع مضاعفة أعداد الكتب فيها لتصبح من أكبر المكتبات اللاهوتية في الشرق الأوسط. وقد شملت مرحلة البناء الإصلاحات والتجديدات الكبرى في كافة منشآت الكلية مثل مبنى الطلاب والمطعم والأسوار ومداخل الكلية، وكذلك إنشاء كانتين وملعب متعدد الأطوار. وتم تخطيط وتنفيذ مشروع امتداد الكلية لخدمة الكنيسة والمجتمع، ويشمل الامتداد مركز خدمة الكنيسة والمجتمع ومركز مارثا روي للعبادة والوعظ ومكتب لخدمة and alumni center, distance learning office, and a well-equipped studio to serve ETSC programs. Also, a breakthrough happened in the ETSC relations locally and internationally, which contributed to securing the support sources necessary for the stability of ETSC and its growth, along with the gradual improvement of the work environment at all levels. This phase was culminated by establishing the Center for Middle Eastern Christianity, CMEC, in an awesome inauguration that was attended by Reverend Dr. Kenneth Bailey, the major partner to this vision. The CMEC contains Kenneth Bailey's specialized library and a museum of rare manuscripts. The third phase المرحلة الثالثة هي مرحلة الانطلاق إلى العالمية من عام 2012 إلى 2016، والتي بدأت مع الاحتفال العالمي بمرور 150 سنة على تأسيس الكلية. ولقد صارت الكلية في رحلة طويلة لتطوير برامجها لتكون بحسب معايير أكاديمية دولية دقيقة، حيث تم طرح العديد من البرامج الأكاديمية التي صار عددها 9 برامج في مجالات متنوعة. وعقدت الكلية خلال هذه الفترة شراكات أكاديمية مع أعرق كليات اللاهوت بالعالم.
All these efforts أثمرت كل هذه الجهود في حصول الكلية على الاعتماد الأكاديمي عام 2021 من المجلس الأوروبي للتعليم اللاهوتي. وتستعد الكلية الآن لبدء برنامج الدكتوراه في الخدمة ديمن بالشراكة مع كلية لاهوت فولر، وكذلك درجة الدكتوراه PhD بالشراكة مع كليات لاهوت بأوروبا والشرق الأوسط. كذلك تلعب الكلية دورا هاما في تطوير التعليم اللاهوتي بالمنطقة من خلال الشراكة الجادة مع رابطة كليات اللاهوت في الشرق الأوسط. المرحلة الرابعة وهي مرحلة الاستدامة، وتشمل السنوات الخمس الأخيرة أي من عام 2016 إلى عام 2021. قامت الكلية خلالها بوضع خطة استراتيجية للتأكد من وجود مقومات النمو والنجاح في الكلية على كافة الأصعدة، مما يساعد على ضمان استمرار استقرار الكلية وتقدمها في كافة الجوانب المعنية. وفي النهاية يقول الدكتور عاطف: عندما أنظر إلى الوراء وأرى ما تحقق، لا يسعني إلا أن أقدم الشكر الجزيل لله الذي قبل أن يستخدم إمكاناتي المحدودة في تحقيق الكثير من النجاحات واجتياز العديد من التحديات. لقد كان دوري الأساسي هو مساعدة زملائي الأكفاء من الأساتذة والموظفين وتشجيعهم على تقديم أفضل ما لديهم لخدمة الكنيسة.
وأيضا تقديم المعلومات والتقارير الأمينة مجلس الكلية للقيام بدوره في قيادة الكلية. أخيرا في تشجيع أصدقاء الكلية بالداخل والخارج على الاستثمار في مكان يستحق كل دعم. هذه اللحظات التاريخية نذكر بالتقدير الدور الذي استخدم الله فيه الدكتور القس عاطف مهني في إدارة الكلية بدعم كبير من مجلسها وأساتذتها والعاملين فيها. ويحمل الدكتور القس هاني حنا العميد الجديد للكلية الكثير من الرؤى لتطوير خدمة الكلية وتعميقها والبناء على ماضيها بتطلع نحو مستقبل واعد يحمل في طياته المزيد من العمل والخدمة لمجد الله وحده.
يستطيع الرب بي أن يصنع العجائب وإن طلبت تكريسي هل يستجيب الطلب؟
Can the Lord do wondrous things through me and if I ask him to dedicate my life for him will he answer my request? Yes. Let us stand up and offer these words to the Lord. Can the Lord do wondrous things through me and if I ask him to dedicate me for him will he answer my request? Can the Lord do wondrous things through me? And if I ask him to dedicate me for him, will he answer my request? Yes, 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 says our Lord. Consecrate yourselves for the work. Tomorrow I will work through you. My wonders are in your midst. My wonders are in your midst. Can the Lord sanctify this body with its weakness and inability? Can he dwell in it forever? Can the Lord sanctify this body with its weakness and inability? Can he dwell in it forever? Yes, 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 says the Lord. Consecrate yourselves for the work. Tomorrow I will work through you. My wonders are in your midst. Can the Lord bless my ministry? Dedicating all of me for his glory? Can the Lord bless my ministry? Dedicating all of me for his glory? Yes, 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 says our Lord. Consecrate yourselves for the work. Tomorrow I will work through you. My wonders are in your midst. Please be seated.
المكرمين النهاردة أو الدكتور الأسيس عاطف والدكتور الأسيس هاني وصفيف طويل
the bios of those we are honoring today Reverend Dr. عاطف and Reverend Dr. هاني are very long bios but I will select some points that may serve as highlights of their journey and ministry. Reverend Dr. عاطف is married to Mrs. Manel Murad. He has two sons, Amir and Nair, and two granddaughters, Tia and Nicole Amir. Reverend Dr. عاطف grew up in the Second Evangelical Church in Asyut and was ordained elder there in 1990. Reverend Dr. عاطف and Reverend Dr. هاني, before they got into ministry, they both graduated from the Faculty of Engineering. Reverend Dr. عاطف graduated in 1982 and Reverend هاني in 1992. Reverend Dr. عاطف ministered since 1984 in the Training Center of Asyut. He graduated from ETSC in 1992 and was selected in the same year to be a demonstrator there. He earned his master's degree from Aberdeen in 1995 and his PhD from the same university in 2000. He was appointed president of ETSC in 2000 and was ordained as pastor of theological education in the Synod of the Nile in 2002. He was head of the Synod in 2017. He authored several writings and presented numerous academic papers in international conferences. He was head of the Association of Theological Institutes in the Middle East, ATIME, from 2001 to 2004. He stepped down from his position as president of ETSC on the 1st of August of this year to return to his role as professor of the New Testament at ETSC and become the director of the Center for Middle Eastern Christianity, CMEC. Reverend Dr. هاني is married to Mrs. Lucy Wilson. They have a daughter, Salma, and a son, Yusuf. He was full-time minister for several years in the youth ministry at the Second Evangelical Church in Almania. He was ordained pastor in the Evangelical Church in 2002. In 2003, he got his master's from Yale in the United States. And in 2013, he earned his PhD from Princeton Theological Seminary in the U.S. He served as academic dean at ETSC from 2013 through 2020. He assumed the presidency of ETSC effective from the 1st of August 2021. He wrote several works in Arabic and English, out of which I pick a book in English titled The Christology. The word Christology means the branch of theology that studies Christ. So the title is The Christology of Karl Barth and Matt al-Miskin. He also authored books in Arabic, and I choose a chapter or a book titled The Philosophy of the Christian Religion, which will soon be published in Lebanon. We thank our Lord for their lives and ministry. And now, as ETSC, we offer a present that falls short of expressing the magnitude of the service, faithfulness, and dedication demonstrated by Reverend Dr. عاطف جندي over this past time as a demonstrator or a president, or now as a director of the Center for Middle Eastern Christianity. I want to invite you all to stand up, and I want to ask Reverend Dr. Andrea Zeki to present this memorial gift on behalf of ETSC to Reverend Dr. عاطف جندي.
أحبائي بحسب برضو البرنامج الموضوع أمامنا هنستمع لكلمتين. الكلمة الأولى
Now, friends, according to the program set before you, we will listen to two speeches. The first is from Dr. Atif Gindi. Then we will listen to a piece of music presented by Elder Dr. Sameh Samir. Then a speech by Dr. Hani Yusuf. Afterwards, we will again enjoy a time of singing with our brother, Engineer Nasif Subhi.
جناب الفاضل دكتور القس أندريا زكي الصديق العزيز رئيس طيفتنا. جناب الفاضل
Reverend Dr. أندريا زكي, my dear friend and head of our denomination, Reverend Kamal, head of the August Synod, Reverend Yusuf Samir, chairman of the board of our seminary, and my dear friend and pastor of this church that always hosts us, members of the August board, most of whom I can see here, and my dear friend, Reverend Dr. Haney, president of ETSC. Honorable guests, whom I wish I could mention by name or by group, as some of you came from far away to honor me with their coming, and some had to cut their vacation short to honor us by their attendance here. And our guests who follow online in various ways. Dr. Andrea asked me whether I would be long in my speech. Actually, today I will tell you something, but I don't know how you will feel about it. I think I need to borrow the spirit of Reverend Baqi Sadaqa, our father, who used to say, you came by your free will, but you will get out of here by our will. So it's a big problem to have to express what you want to say in a few minutes. But I will try to be brief in these few minutes by following the Presbyterian tradition of speaking in three points. The first word is gratitude and gratefulness. Firstly, I need to thank the ETSC board for this tradition that is considered new to our old seminary that is now almost 160 years old. I think it's the first time to hold an honoring celebration for someone who is still alive and a celebration of someone who is taking over the responsibility. Therefore, I am thankful to them for this generous and noble tradition. I want to express my gratitude to various boards I ministered with. And I can see some of their members present here, and I cannot describe the support and assistance that I received from them. I want to thank my family, and this is not pulpit talk, but my family, Manel, my wife, is really a life partner for better, for worse. She takes care of the details of my life and concerns herself with the details of my life. So this big success of mine, I offer to her as a present. And my sons, actually, who are now friends of mine, Amir and Nair and their wives, but the grandchildren, I cannot yet say they have a role in my life except that they re-energize me. But my sons took an interest in all the important events, my travels, the board meetings, the graduation ceremonies, various things. They would pray for me, be occupied with me, creating PowerPoints for me on some occasions, help me, criticize me. You know, their harsh criticism. You did that, you did not do that, you said that, you looked this way, you didn't look that way, but you are a great blessing in my life. I'm also thankful to my second evangelical church in Asyut. I am honored by the presence of its pastor who came especially to attend this event, my friend Pastor Rafi. But actually, this church played a very important role in shaping my life. Spiritual fathers like Reverend Baqi and Dr. Ahmed Ramzi, who are both now in heaven, and other big names, but I cannot mention all of them lest I forget any.
And many of my own generation are here, and I am honored by their presence. They are the ones through whose challenge, love, encouragement, and prayer I am who I am today. I also want to express my gratitude to my colleagues, the faculty, staff, the workers who throughout the past 20 years accepted my leadership, bore with me. And oftentimes I would joke with them saying, you do the work, I get the credit. Always at the end, the ETSC board would thank whom? They would thank the president. But the fact is that they are the ones who actually do the work. But my role, as was mentioned in the documentary, was to facilitate their job because they are dedicated and competent and capable of achieving this success. But honestly, I am not hiding this. In many cases, they would tell me to say or not to say something, do this and do not do that, and I had to obey, of course. I want to express a special gratitude to ministry partners in the region, Egypt, and worldwide, heads of academic institutes, and ministry organizations and bigger churches. I am touched by many of them who supported us in every way possible, including that they invested in a seminary and in a person, although perhaps at a certain stage neither ETSC nor myself seemed to be a winning horse that is worth the investment. Therefore, I express my thanks to them, and I think that some of them are following us online now. I am also deeply indebted to friends who inundated me, as you can see in the booklet between your hands, with very gentle words. And there is more that we could not include in the booklet for time constraints. But they filled me with true feelings of love. And of course, before and above everyone else, thanks be to God, from whom and through whom and to whom are all things. To him be glory, who in his extraordinary love accepted to use someone like me, because many of the successes achieved were not in the areas of my excellent abilities and strengths. But God made them, and we can say this is the finger of God. This was my first point. My second point is an acknowledgement and admittance. I want to admit two things. I am definitely indebted to those who created this documentary that says a lot and is full of praise and encouragement. But if you ask me about the most important achievements that I don't think were mentioned here, I think the most important achievements were the relationships and friendships I came out with and that I am leaving to ETSC, Dr. Haney. Relationships and friendships are the most important achievement in my view. The clean reputation of ETSC, I think this is one of the things we are proud of. Investment in people, it's more important than buildings that perhaps became in better shape, and producing leadership for ETSC that is capable of leading it for generations. And the most prominent example is Dr. Haney, who is much better than me. And today we are celebrating handing the responsibility over to him. Also, the healthy environment that is characterized by love and respect and acceptance of diversity and embracing differences. This is the environment of ETSC. It is one of the things I cherish and consider as an achievement that might be more important than what was mentioned. This is not to diminish what was done. I also acknowledge that this honoring being held today, however very touching, I have to admit that it was not the first honoring. Over 21 years, and maybe this could be something that I leave to you too, Dr. Haney. God honors us in different ways. Sometimes there is gratitude and thankfulness from people who would come over and say, we were influenced by you in this word, this lecture, and this is encouraging. Honoring sometimes comes when you see the fruit of the work of your hands, when you see a plan, a program, a challenge, or something that was accomplished and see its success or positive impact on the church. This is an honoring. And sometimes events and relationships were made available to me that I had not even dreamed about, and training courses and international conferences that I had not dreamed about. If it were not for the ministry, I would not have been part of those events. This is an honoring. And sometimes divine honoring would come through more responsibilities and duties God puts on your shoulders. This is an honoring because it implies divine confidence. And sometimes honoring comes in the form of bigger challenges and difficulties. Open your eyes and embrace them, because it is, as Jesus said, a disciple is not above his teacher. It is enough for the disciple to be like his teacher and the servant like his master. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebul, how much more will they malign those of his household? Thus, the disciples understood the lesson and considered this a reward and got out rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer dishonor for the name. This too is an honoring. Lastly, passing the baton. Here I address my words to my brother and friend, Dr. Haney, president of ETSC. Haney, you were my student, then partner in my ministry and partner in my success and partner in my challenges. You are the one who ministered with me the most and the longest over the past years. I now rejoice as I hand over my place as a ship captain, and I feel reassured to be one of the passengers on board and be among your helpers and be under your leadership. Haney, today I am delivering to you two symbolic things, and they mean a lot to me. The first thing that I am delivering to you
هو عصا سباق التتابع
is a token.
Relay race.
It is
عصا سباق التتابع.
The relay baton.
مكتوب عليه from عاطف
the relay race baton.
هاني حنة
the relay race baton. And there is written on it from عاطف جندي to هاني حنة and our terms of office.
سباق التتابع والعصاية دي بالنسبة
I put
لي ليها معنى
the starting point, but of course I kept it open. May God give you a long life to serve the longest time possible. The relay and this baton mean a lot to me. Firstly, they say that you and I and those who preceded us run round the track. That was all I did, but my track was a bit longer, 21 years. We run round the track, but this track is the kingdom of God, and we are part of it. So I do not think, and it should not be depicted as if I were the maker of history, nor you. But I was handed down this responsibility from another, and I am handing it over to you today. But there is also something else, another important meaning, Dr. Haney, I'd love to say to you. The one who runs round the track not only receives the baton, but also hands it over. And this is very important, though not written in the job description of the president of ETSC. But take it as the job description and its summary. As you received this responsibility of ETSC, find someone from day one, keep an eye, and pray that our Lord will guide you to whom you should hand over the responsibility. The challenge is to find someone better than you, and it is really difficult to find someone better than Haney, but this is a responsibility on you. The third and last thing in the meaning of this symbol is that there is no one while playing a sport, no matter how difficult, sweaty, or hard it is, or even if it involves running like this relay does, like this relay does this sadly. So please enjoy the role and do not groan because of it. As you practice it, enjoy it. Do not groan as you exercise this role. This is the first symbol I offer you, Dr. Haney. And the second symbol is the flag of the seminary, the flag of ETSC, which I did my best and as much as God helped me to deliver it raised. So do your best, please, to hand it over more raised than it was when you received it. Reverend Dr. Andrea, head of the Evangelical Denomination, Reverend Kamal Rushdie, head of the Synod, Reverend Dr. Yusuf Samir, chairman of the board of ETSC, honorable members of the board, my colleague and brother and teacher, Dr. Atif Gindi, my colleagues, the faculty of ETSC, our guests, both in the church and online, welcome to you. I studied numerous courses in my life, whether at ETSC or elsewhere, but there is not a single course that I studied can qualify me to deliver the speech I am expected to give today. Assuming the presidency of ETSC is a very high honor, but at the same time an impressive responsibility. It was not possible for me to be present here today if it were not for so many of those present here, whether on the platform or down here or outside the church, who are not present with us today. If it were not for your encouragement, your love, your friendship, your help, you are an inherent part of my assuming this big responsibility and being granted such high honor. I am thankful to the board of ETSC under the leadership of Dr. Reverend Yusuf Samir for his trust that was manifested in assigning this responsibility to me and granting me this honor. I am looking forward to working with the board and the work team of ETSC in the stewardship of caring for this treasure. This treasure that is called ETSC. I am thankful to you, Dr. Atif. Without you, I wouldn't be here. Thank you for the space you gave me. Thank you for your humility and self-giving in an impactful ministry for both ETSC and the church. I learned a lot from you. Firstly, as a professor of the New Testament, it is true I was his student, and then he was my boss at work and also as a colleague and as a friend. Your impact on me is symbolic of the impact of ETSC on me during the different phases of my life. I studied my first theological academic program at ETSC, which had a huge influence on my intellectual development, spiritual growth, and personal maturity. Also studying two programs abroad, the master's and the PhD programs, were through the encouragement of ETSC and under its care. I am thankful to my colleagues in the seminary from the bottom of my heart, the faculty, staff, the workers. Thank you for encouraging me before and after assuming this responsibility. I'm looking forward to working with you in the time ahead to fulfill dreams that we dreamed together and new dreams. And may God enable me to serve you.
I want to thank all the guests, whether here in the church or on the internet, for taking of your precious time to share this moment with us. I am thankful to my colleagues, the ministers from the various church ministries. I am grateful to the ministry partners in all parts of the world. May God bless our relations so that we may grow together in serving the gospel of Jesus Christ. There are people whose presence in my life and their ministry to me is a major cause for my continuation, growth in ministry, and fulfilling my church vocation. And I have a lot to say on this, so I will only mention examples. Reverend Dr. Faiz Faris, Reverend Mahrous Habib, Elder Yusuf Qustandi Hanna, Elder Yusuf Nathan, Elder Magid Murqus, Elder Mufid Gamil. I am thankful to them and thankful to God for them. I saw Christ in them. They planted and watered a lot in my life. There are people who left a strong impression on my educational journey and my intellectual formation. Reverend Dr. Darren Kennedy, Dr. Stephen Davis, Dr. David Kelsey, Dr. Bruce McCormick, Bishop Epiphanius of St. Macarius Monastery, Father Henry Boulet, the Jesuit. I owe them and many others a lot, really a lot. I want to thank my wife, Lucy, who moved along with me through my life journey in so many places. Every time I would tell her, it is a transitional stage. This time she said, I know, it is a transitional stage. What Dr. Atif said confirms this. We run round a track. I thank her and thank my family. Sifa is present today. Salma is not present. They are a great delight for my life. Without Lucy's support, constant, spontaneous love, sacrificial service for me and my family, it would have been impossible for me to fulfill God's call on my life. Above all, I thank God for His faithfulness in my life and His faithfulness for ETSC throughout the last 160 years since 1863 until today. As I look at the immense responsibility, I wonder who is sufficient for these things, and the answer is obvious. No one is sufficient for these things. I am by no means sufficient for these things, but I rely on God's grace. My colleagues and I rely on the grace of God that is sufficient in our weakness and that works through and in spite of our weakness to achieve His good will. I will talk about three passages that represent my understanding of theological education before I start my ministry. And it is good to know how I think before I start. There are three passages in the Word of God that articulate succinctly and clearly my understanding of the core of the message of theological education. The first passage is Colossians 1, verse 28. Him we proclaim, warning everyone and teaching everyone with all wisdom, that we may present everyone mature in Christ. The mission of ETSC is to equip ministers to pastor and lead the church into witnessing to the gospel of Christ in the church and society, the gospel of love, the gospel of justice, and the gospel of peace. And this biblical passage emphasizes the centrality of Christ Jesus to theological education. Christ is not just a topic of a subject taught or a doctrine taught. He is rather the essence of the message and the goal of forming the life of ETSC community, the students, faculty, administrative staff, and workers. The goal of academic theological education is for students to grow in the knowledge, love, and service of God who revealed Himself in Jesus Christ, and to develop creative contextual frameworks that help the church to proclaim the gospel of reconciliation and testify to the kingdom of God by establishing the values of truth, good, and beauty. The second passage is 2 Timothy 3, verse 16. All scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness. This passage emphasizes the centrality of the Word of God as the only statute for doctrine, that is, for knowing God, and for works, that is, for obeying God and testifying to Him, and for the affection and attitude, that is, the life of piety and trusting God. Therefore, it is the foundation and criterion of growth in Christ and offering the right witness about God in the church and society. The third passage is 2 Timothy 2, verse 2, and what you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses and trust to faithful men who will be able to teach others also. This passage refers to the deep-rootedness of theological education in a dynamic heritage that moves forward to the future and the ocean in which theological education swims is the ocean of a reformed Presbyterian tradition in a Middle Eastern context. These three dimensions are the foundations of the sustainability of the mission of ETSC in the coming stage, and the success of ETSC in its ministry is essentially contingent on our commitment to these dimensions. The third passage I quoted today from the Word of God and what you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses reflects the last idea that Dr. Atif mentioned, and I hope I will be able to follow these steps that you mentioned, Dr. Atif. I will do that, and please pray for me. Thank you for your attendance and attention, and please pray for me and for ETSC. May God be with you. I testify about my God before all creation. I testify about a love that surpassed all limits. I testify about my life and the relationship with the Beloved, and say from a trustful heart, no other lover is like Him.
I testify about his beauty and the compassion of his gentle heart. Through his care and abundant peace, the worries of the journey go away. Since I met my Lord, I found the meaning of life. My cup overflows with his love. The joys of my heart are found in him. I committed my heart. I dedicated my love. I offered my soul to you, Lord. I committed my heart. I dedicated my love. I offered my soul to you, my Lord. I am yours. All of me is yours. And you are mine. Here in my sojourn, you lead me. You accompany me. With your spirit, you lead my steps. I will shout for joy, glorifying you throughout the years. I will sing to you because you are my helper. I will submit to your voice all the time. Yes, amen, amen. I committed my heart. I dedicated my love. I offered my soul to you, Lord. To you, my Lord. Dear friends, please welcome with me Reverend Dr. Andrea Zeki, who will deliver the speech of our ceremony this evening.
نعم. نسمك أنا لايف. اسمحوا لي أتكلم وأنا قاعد عشان.
Allow me to speak sitting down so that the paper may be close to me. I cannot see everything written standing up.
أقف هنا. بيقول إيه؟ أنا افتكرتك عايزني أقف هنا. الحمد لله أعطيني. أولاً أهني الأسيس كمال رشدي رئيس.
First of all, I congratulate Reverend Kamal Rushdie, head of the Synod, and Reverend Yusuf Samir, chairman of the board, and Dr. Atif and Dr. Haney, and I think it is a noble and honorable occasion where the Evangelical Church of Egypt practices what I call rotation of responsibility. And it is, as Dr. Atif mentioned, a new thing. As far as I know, it is the first time we do it. I do not know if it was done before or not, but I am proud and happy to belong to this body that believes in the rotation of responsibility, not rotation of power, but rotation of responsibility. And as a matter of fact, on any occasion, I like to address the church at large, and my message is a brief message. I know you are tired by now and have heard a lot of beautiful speeches, but it will be based on Psalm 8. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. This psalm, over the past 6 months, I have talked about it on several occasions in various and several ways. And today, my message is, change your place and your vision will improve.
change your place and your vision will improve. I think when King David was locked in the palace, was unable to see but his own lusts, desires, and personal needs. He committed adultery with Bathsheba, killed Uriah the Hittite, and created some real problems. But the moment the king decided to get out above the walls of the palace, he saw something new. He saw new dimensions. He saw new visions. And the message I am saying to myself today and to my ministry partners is change your position and you will see something better. And your life develops differently. When the astronaut went up to the moon and saw the universe differently, he got a different vision. The real problem that faces many of us as a church leaders is that oftentimes we lock ourselves in a system of ideas, limited visions, palaces we make by ourselves that limit us. They make us narrow-minded. They give us narrow visions. Today, the message I am delivering to myself is change your place, change your position, change your role. When you change your place and change your position, you will see the world differently and you will acquire new and different experiences so long as you lock yourself in a certain system and are unable to make a daring decision by going out of it, your vision will be limited. Therefore, this is importantly related to breaking free from one's self. When you alter your place and change your position and get out of your own self, you get to see new experiences. Those without new experiences with our Lord, those without new experiences in life, those who are unable to see new aspects lose. Their lives become loose and superficial for many years. Their thoughts become limited and their views of life become limited. We wouldn't have been able to imagine the idea of weightlessness unless the humans have gone to space and from a different place they witnessed a different experience. And in your relationship with God, you need in many cases to alter your place so that you may have a new experience where you can see things you were not able to see. Churches improve, organizations improve, nations improve when people have new experiences. Many people are frozen by the past and they froze the past. Many people do not know anything about the future. They always live in the past. All their experiences are about the past. It is good to have experiences in the past, but if we do not have new experiences toward the future, we will not be able to improve the future. Change your position, you will change. Change your position, you will see new things. I'm not talking only about rotation of responsibility, like what we are seeing today in ETSC, but I'm talking about my spiritual life, my personal and my practical life. We are in a bad need to get out of our own selves, out of the palaces we are locked in, out of the ideas that oppress us, out of the traditional visions that made us for many years locked in the past, and the past hemmed us in, and we became unable to look ahead to the future. This is a message I am sending to myself. I need to change my place and my stances in order to be able to see new things I was unable to see. Today, I came particularly to congratulate Dr. Hani, or I address him as Hani because he is from my local church and a younger brother to me. But I also want to address a word to Dr. Atif Gindi. I have written the word, but I will not read it out. It is
mostly included in the booklet, and you can read it later.
Atif
is the leader of my wife, Hela. So, Hela is present. She told me I have to attend. Atif, you played a big role at PTSC, and you served in faithfulness, in integrity, and in uprightness. You served in faithfulness, in integrity, and in uprightness.
Atif
is a conservative, enlightened theologian who holds fast to the Word of God. Professor of the New Testament of the highest order, who enjoys capabilities in understanding the scripture that are very distinguished. You carried ETSC into new land, and you managed to earn European accreditation for ETSC, which is an important accreditation. You improved the curricula. You played an important part in making ETSC one of the important seminaries in the Middle East. Were there challenges? There were challenges. Were there problems? There were problems. Were there some people who took advantage of some situations? There were. But you served ETSC and the church in uprightness. Please give a round of applause to Dr. Atif Gindi.
دكتور عاطف مهني صاحب يدين نظيفتين.
دكتور عاطف جندي is a man of clean
عالم
hands.
من علماء العهد الجديد. ابن
a
بار للكنيسة.
Of the New Testament.
ينتمي إليها.
A good son
أحد
of the church.
أحد قادتها الذين نحترمهم.
One of its men, one of its
leaders عشان تشوف رؤى جديدة.
You are changing your place today to see new visions, to see new dreams, and to visualize things you have not seen before. I always say the best days are the days we have not lived yet, because we believe in Jesus Christ and trust His providence and care. Congratulations on what has passed by, and congratulations on what is coming ahead. And the days ahead are the days when you will give the church manifold and manifold and manifold. Dr. Haney, ETSC is an immense responsibility and requires a strenuous effort. We are enlightened conservatives. We adhere to the Word of God. No one outbids us, and we do not outbid anyone. And I am glad that you presented your credentials to the Egyptian church at large, and was glad to hear what I heard from you. I pray that God will use you more mightily. You are a highly regarded scholar, a distinguished researcher, precise, a pure person who fears God. I also congratulate ETSC on the new role of Dr. Atif Gindi. I congratulate ETSC on the new president, Dr. Haney. Please also give him a great round of applause. At the end, I am grateful to all our guests, the parliament members present here, our priests, archbishops, and leaders from other churches and our church people and leaders. I am grateful for what is happening. I am grateful for what is happening this evening. It is an important milestone on the road of rotation of responsibility, on the road of new visions, on the road towards the future, depending on the grace of God and armored by the grace of God, with a conservative, enlightened vision that is capable of illuminating the whole world. Thank you for listening. Dear friends, in conclusion, I would love to express my thanks to you all for honoring us by your attendance today to share our thanking to the Lord and our dreams of a brighter future for ETSC in the time ahead. I want to express my special thanks to Reverend Dr. Andrea Zaki, head of the Evangelical Denomination in Egypt, and Reverend Kamel Rushdie, head of the Evangelical Synod of the Nile, Engineer Nasif Subhi, who led us in singing, Dr. Samih Samir, who presented the piece of music. I also want to express my special gratitude to our guests, members of the House of Representatives and the Senate, who graciously attended with us today. Special thanks to Mr. Tariq Al-Khouli, member of the House of Representatives, Ms. Nada Alfi Thabit, member of the House of Representatives, Mr. Hadi Louise, member of the Senate. I also extend my thanks to the heads of the different evangelical denominations. And I mention in particular Reverend Dr. Munir Subhi, head of the Baptist Convention, Reverend Atif Sidham, head of the General Conference of the Wesleyan Standard Churches, Reverend Dr. Latif Ramsis, head of the Church of God Assembly. I also express my gratitude to some public figures who honored us by their attendance. Mr. Girgis Saleh, Secretary of the Permanent Committee of the Eastern Orthodox Patriarchs in the Middle East and former General Secretary of the Middle East Council of the Churches, Engineer Tariq Al-Nabarawi, former head of the Engineers Syndicate, Engineer Tharwat Samuel, Vice President of the Evangelical Fellowship of Egypt and Editor-in-Chief of the Tariq newspaper, friends of ETST abroad or who are watching the event online, Reverend Gabi Ailaboni, Dr. Luay Mahmoud Saeed, Manager of the Center for Coptic Studies of Biblioteca Alexandrina, Father Benjamin al-Muharraqi, priest of Al-Anbar West Church. I also thank Reverend Dr. Bishoy Rasmi, President of the Catholic College of Human and Theological Sciences in Al-Ma'adi and member of the Executive Committee of Egypt Council of the Churches, representing His Eminence Pope Ibrahim Ishaq, Patriarch of the Coptic Catholics of Egypt. I also thank His Grace Archbishop George Shehan and the delegates accompanying him. He is the Archbishop of the Cairo Maronite Bishopric of Egypt and Sudan and the senior head of the Maronite Organization in Egypt and the Apostolic Visitor of Africa. I also extend my thanks to Reverend Dr. Camille William, Professor of the Old Testament in Catholic Seminaries and friend of ETSC. Thanks are also due to the leaders of the Evangelical Synod of the Nile as represented by the members of the Executive Committee of the Synod and the heads and secretaries of the various presbyteries present here. I also extend my thanks to the leaders of the Coptic Evangelical Organization for Social Services, SEUS, and the leaders of the Bible Society. I also thank the organizing committee of this celebration under the leadership of Reverend Dr. Tharwat Wahba. Dear friends, I once again express my thanks to you all for your attendance. Now, let us stand up together to conclude with the last song with Engineer Nasif Subhi. Afterwards, Reverend Dr. Andrea Zaki will lead us in a closing prayer and the benediction. Let us sing these words. I love the Lord not to gain heaven, nor for fear of hell, but I love him because his love is sweet for me, and he is the one who freely loved me first. I love the Lord not to gain heaven, nor for fear of hell. I love the Lord not to gain heaven, nor for fear of hell. I love him because his love is sweet for me, and because he first loved me freely.
but I love him. And because he loved me freely first, do I then worship the one who removed my guilt for gaining heaven or for fear of hell? Do I then worship the one who removed my guilt for gaining heaven or for fear of hell? No, but as my Lord loved me and his attributes proved to be highly noble, my heart loves him. No, but as my Lord loved me and his attributes proved to be highly noble, my heart loves him. Our Lord, all thanks be to you, because in your light we see light. Thank you for ETSC and its history, for those who served and are serving, for the responsibility that you assigned for theological education that proclaims the Word of God and builds the souls and presents the reality and truth. Bless us and protect us because we pray in the name of Jesus, the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us and lasts in us now and forever. Amen.